为了要等一下一起来，然后所以那个麻烦，now we are going to have a Q&A， yeah， 所以后面有新颖在帮大家准备递麦克风啊，所以我想要看看说就是有没有谁要先来发那第一个问题，可以问 Julian 跟那个李局长，就是关于这个相关的问题这样子，有没有哪位要先来举个手来？
Thank you, Julian. Sorry, my English is poor, so I try my best. There are over 5,000 projects in Paris, but how can we know the each citizen, each people, each person can know the 5,000 projects, the details, because it is too difficult to know each details. If they are divided with 21 regions, there are still 250 projects in each region. So, is there any easy way to make sure each person know the details before they vote? Thank you.
Indeed, there was more than 5,000 IDs submitted by the people. It doesn't mean that at the vote there will be 5,000, because a lot of them are had to be rejected, unfortunately, because they were not respecting the criteria, or they were just impossible to do, or sometimes it was even too expensive. Like, for example, there is a kind of river, a canal, which is going under Paris, and so they wanted to reopen it to open air. So it is not impossible, it's just a huge amount of money that you need that, to do that. So in this case, we can't accept the project. Other projects were not possible to do because, for example, you want to do something, you want to renovate a place, or you want to do something on the wall, and the wall doesn't belong to the city. So you can't do it. It belongs to a private person or a group of people. So in that case, we can't submit the project to the vote. So at the end, there is actually between 10 and 77 projects on the list. So the most is on the Parisian scale, it's indeed 77. So the people has to pick up 10 choices, 10 projects. Amongst the 77. So it's indeed, if we want the people vote, we can't give a full detail about the project. It can't be a little book for every project, because otherwise the people will never go through the 77 books in order to know what they will choose. So we have to make a description of the project which is quite easy to understand and efficient.
Your English is poor. Me too. 所以我们中间有那个翻译的伙伴呢，帮我们翻译。所以等一下可以问中文也没关系。还没有，哎，新颖麻烦一下。
我想请问一下 Julian， 就是刚才提到那些十到限期的提案里面，其实像在台湾或是可能在法国，其实很多人还是不太会使用网络，那如果要透过这种群众表达意见的这种线上平台，会不会影响到说，可能今天一般不会用网络的人就没有办法深入的去了解各个提案，就没有办法表达自己的意见？
It's okay if I understand, if I answer in English?
Yes.
So there is indeed many questions in the question, because indeed there is, it's not only person or the people who can use the internet and who can submit project or who can check the website to know the project. So we pay really a lot of attention to that, because we don't want to segregate the people who are not connected to the internet. So we try to duplicate everything. One thing online, one thing physical. So we do physical meetings, and we also have different places in Paris where, when it is the time that people can submit ideas, so there's different places that people can go, and they will meet a civil servant, which will be there to help them. They will help them to make a project with more detail, but they will also help them to type and to implement their ID inside the platform. During the vote, it is the same. You can vote online, but you can vote also on papers, and we have printed little books for each district and for the Parisian PB, in order that people can just read the books. So you need how to read, that's true. And so this is the limit that we have. And we are to improve also on the minority aspect. For example, for the disabled people, for the people which are blind or deaf, we have to improve our systems in order to be sure that they can have access to STEM participation.
How? 那后面我非常生疏，就继续在追问。你还是用麦克风好了，大家听都比较听得到。
我还是想问一下，就是这样的参与式预算其实已经蛮成功，而且影响市民。那它是否有直接，比如说造成民调的升高，或者累积政治的声望，这样就蛮实际，就是对好计划怎么会一直延续下去？但这我觉得这是一个关键。
Alors, c'est une expérience qui était, it's an experience which is quite recent. We can't really tell already, okay, the popularity increased 20 points because thanks to the participatory budget. What we have for the moment, that we made some poll, and since the beginning of the process, we can see that the notoriety rate, that the percentage of people who know the PB is growing up. We are still not at 100%, but we are. It's increasing. And the good thing is that all the people who know the process are very happy about it, and they really approve it. On the political aspect, it was quite interesting also, because for Paris it was quite new to do such a process, a PB process. And something to know important, that a big difference between Taipei and Paris is that the mayor of Paris is elected by the council. So normally there's no problem between the mayor and the majority of the council. So when the mayor wants to pass a law at the council, she doesn't have to struggle that much with the council. I heard that sometimes it can be a big difference between the city council and the mayor, and so it might be a lot of negotiation here in Taiwan. But so just to come back to our case, in that within the Paris Council, the opposition, the party, the other party, the minority party, first had an attitude of observation. They didn't want to criticize, they didn't want to support this process because it was too new for them. And they saw after the first year that the people were very happy about it. So now they are supporting the PB process. So that's also politically very interesting for the mayor, because she are implementing policies which are unanimous, which are doing the unanimity.
问题是给两位的，然后再麻烦翻译帮我翻译。就是我很好奇，就是其实两位都提到说，其实政府是一个不一样的 machine， 它的机制跟民间的运作是不太一样的。那我很好奇，就是说在这个参与式预算的过程中，跟民间的互动的过程中，还有在发现中互动的过程中，民间的这样子的弹性的组织的运作，有没有带过来回头改变了政府内部的组织跟它的官僚机器？然后有没有一些比较实际的例子？
那我想就趁着翻译的空档，麻烦你去上线了。
我反正问的问题好难啊。对啊，基本上我们现在没有看到太大的变化，但是组织，我觉得组织这一块比较难看到变化，但是 mindset 也在变化。我觉得这个可能更重要，因为组织要变化，说实在不太容易。对，你要经过什么考选部，不是什么，全序部，然后再到考试院去塞那个萝卜坑，那比较难。但是 mindset 变了，就像刚刚讲说，交通局会去跟我们协调去拿警察局的资料，这个 mindset 在变了。然后接下来就是说没有办法，当不违法的时候，你的态度是什么？因为你知道办法里面其实很多灰色地带，是你可以很严格的去看待一件事情，然后告诉你说这是不行做的。你也可以去想办法帮民众去解决问题，让这件事情可以做的。譬如说我们今天讲说，刚刚讲说创新一下，就像我们要建，像我们这样咨询局要负责 smart city。那你今天你就会发现你到底要 top down approach 还是 bottom up approach， 对？当 top down approach 像我们传统的 top down approach 的时候，你就会发现，奇怪了，民众都不喜欢用，对，关在办公室里面想出来的东西，民众不爱用。可是 bottom up 的时候，像 Uber， 对，你就说它违法。所以当一些好的东西要去出来的时候，突然碰到法规上的限制，但是这时候政府的态度是什么？对，假设他今天是民间企业的态度的话，他不会被限制住的，他可能会 被想办法让这件事情能够发生。可若以政府的角度来看，是以传统角度来看，他不会，他要想办法法规上面你不要造成我们的困扰。所以我就觉得说民间的弹性，今天假设说就像我今天有看到蔡政委他讲的，很欢迎民间的人到政府单位去服役，那就是把一些概念带到政府里面来，去怎么样去用。我觉得 mindset 的改变是现在还可以，已经可以看得到的。那我觉得那就是一个机会。今天我越来越多人这样进去，把新的 mindset 放到政府里面来，那他在这个组织下面还是有些事情可以做的。我觉得还是有事情可以做的。那我回答这边不知道 OK 吗？ OK， 谢谢。
It's your turn. About the participatory budgeting process, we have to adapt the organization. Because we had to do such a work in such a period of time that we totally changed the organization around it. And it's indeed a change in the civil servant's mind. Because now, in the past, they were receiving their orders from the elected members. Now they are receiving their orders almost directly from the citizens. So it's a new relationship that is established between the citizen and the administration. And it is very interesting for that. And so when I was telling that 300 people worked on the PB during the last 3 months, you have to organize that because it's a really, that impact a lot your organization. And you need also to develop strong IT system to manage that. So it is in the same time for the PB at least a change in the organization, and it's a change of culture. It's a change of spirit, and this is the same for the open data. You really have to make the civil servant more open-minded on open data.
好。先刚有一个人传小纸条给我，所以我先代替发问一下，可以请等一下哈。那个想要问 Julian 的是说，他说刚刚有看到 slide 里面有提到参与式的预算比重嘛，其中 25% 是社会环境， 8% 交通， blah blah blah， 加一加以后是 60%， 那还有其他 40% 在哪里？这似乎是一种把钱交出来的概念。
Sorry. events. I can't answer that because I don't have it in mind. But don't worry, we're not tricking, we're not cheating. I can try to look on my computer if I get the details of the other person. I'm a bit mad at myself because last Monday there was somebody who asked me the same question and I couldn't answer and I didn't know for it since. So I will really try to look at it now. And if you give me your email, I can try to send you the answer.
Not in my pocket.
谢谢您简单的翻译。 好，那这样子， 刚刚佩奇有没有？
我想要问局长问题， 然后因为刚好我是来自卫生福利部的， 然后我想帮同事问一个问题， 是在做8仙的案例的时候， 有没有任何的点是你们在做的过程中会希望， 啊， 如果中央也在这个GAN里面就好了， 有没有类似像这样的事情， 我可以带回部内？
那我再找取例子来回答。
对，然后我们的确需要中央的帮助，真的，在整个救灾的过程中，就在救灾的过程里面，的确需要中央帮助。小芳，你们补充一下，卫生福利部可以帮。我现在突然不知道要讲什么。啊，马希文已经是 FB 的朋友，我们私下，这我觉得有些事情真的是遇到的时候才可以这样协调了，突然。
事件过了以后，我们只记得那时候社群就说民主为什么不能开放全民而已，然后大家就一直在讲这件事情。那好像现在能努力，好像就这个哦。我觉得名字那是另外一回事，就是说大家对各自法的认知还是有些落差了，所以那个大概是，我觉得那可能跟卫生福利部没有太大的关系，是大家对这种认知。但是中央跟地方的确不一样，因为灾害是发生在地方。 所以地方已经是第一线的，但是中央有一个权限，在那个地方，它可以 organize 所有的 resources。那怎么样去做这些 resources 的 organization， 跟中央可以扮演很重要的角色。
我突然又想到一点，就是那时候我们事件发生以后，有很多社群来，那大家其实对卫福部灾害当下的系统是有兴趣的，因为看得到那些系统，就可以知道你们还大概还有什么样的资讯，那哪些是能公开就可以再讨论。
我觉得也许可以再办一个，再有一个机会让大家可以一起去检视这样的系统上面资料栏位，那可能就会有更多的可以想象的事情，大概是这样。
所以我们后续有没有再继续做这个可以请卫福部一起来救你？好，对，你想要今天可以抽成这样的东西？<笑>
神奇吧，我们什么人都有，<笑>就不要说叫什么谁谁举手这样子，搞不好什么所谓的高手站民间，其实通都在这里这样子。好，那我们还有一点点时间，那还有没有人有什么问题？来，如同各位所见哦，所以现在台上你暂时只能问到一个，不过等一下我相信回来的时候还是可以再继续回答你问题。对，
居然问一个问题哦，昨天因为有一个成员昨天去听了蔡英文主席的演讲，然后他调侃一下说他绝对不做 IV 五艇。 对，所以还在问说，但是好奇是说，接下来台北市政府在规划中的话 ，i-voting 除了也许对某些居住首长或人选之外，对于政策的施行，甚至对于某些任何项目或执行方式，会不会还有更多的计划要分享或什么？
嗯 ，i-voting 哦，其实应该问资讯局是不对的，你要问研讨会。<笑>对，那原则上以资讯局来讲，我们今天介绍的这种名人，就是你可能会发生各式各样的 i-voting。 所以对市长来讲 ，i-voting 你可以把它视为一个 brand， 不要把它当做 voting。所以你用 voting 就太严肃了，像 JR 每次都骂我们，你搞了什么 voting 乱七八糟。但是我们的 voting 是 brand， 你把它当做是一个 brand。那市长的想法是说，透过不断的这种参与，就会形成某一种氛围。那那个氛围其实就是 create 大家的一种素养。所以刚开始你会看到各局处很多东西可能就会拿出来做所谓的 voting， 其实只是 questionary。 通常只是说做个问卷调查，或是做一个风向的一个调查，它不是那么 serious， 也就是说那些东西其实市长在办公室盖个章就可以决定的事情，但是他可以抛出来看看大家的反应、大家的想法。但在这过程里面，这个系统或是说市民的接受度就越来，像刚才讲说，那很多人都没有网络的，没有网络啊，没有配的，没有电脑，没有手机，那甚至不会，那怎么办？所以中间会有一个过程，一定会有一个过程，但那东西是需要培养的。 所以 eventually 有没有可能台湾才这么小的地方2300万人，我要议员，那可能好像不太讲。 对，那我如果有这个系统之后，是不是直接就诉诸民意了？所以每个人都可以发声的时候，民主会变成什么样子？那是一个可以想象的空间，但这个过程里面不可能跳痛跳那么快，直接就跳到那个 level 去，所以中间可能需要一些过程。那这个过程也许就是 iVoting 系统可以去扮演的一个角色。所以从一些不是很 serious、很严肃的主题开始切进去，然后慢慢也许越来越严肃。对，所以咨询局来讲，我们今天就提供几种 level 试试看。有的是完全不需要验证的，有些可能严格一点需要手机的，也许用像市长讲的用悠游卡，甚至到严谨一点，也许用自然凭证，也许未来用什么，其实我们也不知道。那边上把弹性做出来 ，OK。所以 iVoting 就让大家不要把它视那么严肃，把它就视为是 voting 或是 poll， 它就是一个先是一个 brand， 先去一个试验，然后先让大家去 involve 在这个情境里面，然后去培养一些素养。所以就不断的做，不断的做，不断的做，不断的做，那就会不断的成熟，不断的成熟。对，这是你问咨询局，我就大概只能这样回答了。OK， 谢谢。
OK， 好，那感谢大家帮我控时间哦，时间控的刚刚好，我就在最后一秒钟的时候。那我们先谢谢两位讲者跟翻译哦，那请他们先讲。好，未来高院长，好 ，Let me tell you， we have three groups， three talks， right？Three talks, yeah. So every talk we will have 5 minutes, and I will invite the speakers of the talks. 那个讲者麻烦先到前面排排坐一下吧，这样我们等一下。